G'day everyone, welcome to possibly my last Oathsworn stream, although I'll definitely still be painting Oathsworn, just not sure I'm going to stream too much more of it. Need to get more signal blue. G'day Sammy, g'day Rapid Transit. A quiff. Everything all of the time. A word tweak. Yes, I've been editing videos for this series, and I've finished editing five episodes. I have 7 episodes to go. This is the last one that I'm needing to film the series. The last step to the editing process, once I've fully edited the video, is to record my voiceover. So I'm hoping to do that sometime this week, which will mean I can start releasing videos. Woo. Which is cool. Yes, I hope they're good. I think they're pretty good. I've done a few test screenings to a few people. They also think they're pretty good. So that's all right, I suppose. Now, I do have a request of the chat. The topic, game match fixer, the topic of this paint job, of this episode is going to be freehand. It's the last episode in the series. So I need a subject matter that we can freehand onto the shield. So, the request for those who are familiar with the game and have read the updates around this particular guy. I can't remember it specifically, but I think one of the updates had a full deep dive on the character, which might tell you a little bit about him. I don't know anything about too much of the lore, but wanted to save that for the gameplay, but I need a something we can paint on his shield that's going to make sense in the game, or just something that's going to look cool. So Pascal, thanks for the raid, mate. Welcome, friends. That was your stream, buddy. One. What are you painting? Yeah, I'm good, mate. I'm good. This project's been awesome fun, and I'm very fortunate because at the end of it, I have a whole series of painted models that I get to use when my board game arrives, which is super cool. Awesome. Do you get many box arts? Do you get many jobs for box arts and stuff? Oh, congrats, mate. Sort of a new project. I've been working on it for the last 2 weeks. Here, let me put my face on screen and I'll show you a little bit about what I've been doing. Hello, friend. This is me. Yes, welcome. This is a series of videos that I'm working on for a board game called Oathsworn, and these are all the core heroes from the game. So, I've been putting together tutorials for each of these figures, focusing on a specific sort of topic. So for this guy, like the topic was skin and how to paint skin. So he's a Scar Tribe exile. This is the ranger. So she's her focus was wood, and the way I've tried to approach the painting has been, how can you do this in a quick and interesting way that'll look good on the table. So most of these figures I've spent about 2 hours on. So this is the priest. Topic for him was painting white. And yeah, so again, really, really all about how can I do stuff really quickly, but that still looks good. Which is a tricky balance, right? But I think it's probably what I'm best at. And so all these figures have got basically probably half hour to an hour long tutorial videos that I've got footage for in most cases. I've cut them together. Thanks, Gallifire. Yeah, and so the company that makes the game is really, really awesome. I just wanted to do something for them, so I'm not getting paid or anything. I mean, I got the models a couple of weeks early, but it's not really not getting paid or anything like that, but it's just cool to do some tutorials for them. This model's mad, the bear. Little bear. Ooh. So pretty much all of them I've spent about 2 hours on. This guy. Thunder. Thunder. Thundercats. Oh! And each of the tutorials has a specific topic that I focused on, like what topic is for each of the figures. This one was obviously painting metal. Really happy with this red, by the way. Came out really cool. So I've got 12 figures all up from the core heroes. It's the witch. And this is one I did yesterday, which is the Grove Maiden. So she's a plant monster lady. And she actually has summon. She summons little creatures to fight for her, which is these little missile pod things, and then this big bruiser. So those are all the figures I've painted for the game so far. I've got a tiny little bit of stuff left to do. The filming. Nope, didn't change the witch. Why? What did I change? I don't think I changed anything. Nope. That's just how she was. Right, I'll drop my face off. Boom. Thanks, Al. So what I've really tried to concentrate on is how can I make these figures look cool, but quick. Excellent. Good work, Quiff. So, what's a something we can paint on him? We could probably do a chain down the bottom of this cloak. That could work. But what can we put on the shield? I don't know if a chain on the shield is the go. Keys. Keys could work. We can do cross keys like we did on Sir Percival. Was it Percival? No, it's okay. I did indeed finish Stranger Things, yes. We finished it on Friday night. As usual, we will not do any spoiling. But I was absolutely blown away by the last episode. Fantastic season. Easily, I think, the best season of that show. Can't wait to find out about all of the things in the last two episodes. What did you think of it? G'day, Jet. I thought season two, when it came out, was definitely weaker than season one. But when I rewatched season two, after having watched season three, I felt like it was a lot stronger because you could see that season two was just about setting up for what happened in season three. So. No, let's use this one. Would you get some paint on jet? Yeah, that's a interesting observation. But I understand. The expanse. A little bit of everything all of the time. Okay, so I think what I'm gonna do is I'll just do some quick airbrushing now. Time. A little bit of everything all of the time. Chain links along the border of the shield. Okay. I was sort of leaning towards something like a Teutonic cross or something like that. But do both, I think. A game called Marvel Champions last night. It's a card game. LCG. Living collectible card game. Anyone here played it? Yeah, I don't think that fleur-de-lis is canon, but I feel like I saw one somewhere on the figure. Yeah. Don't know if it's canon or not, but it's sitting right there next to it, so I'll take it. Teutonic cross-shaped Ravenclaw. Yeah, that's a good shout because we got these raven symbols. Okay, so what I think I'm gonna do for the armor on this guy is I'm gonna make it painted armor. So I'm gonna do that by highlighting all of this stuff. And then we'll add scratches later on with metallic paints. That should look pretty cool, I think. It is easy, mate. And I don't say that being a dickhead, but I think we overcomplicate it sometimes. It's just painting little toy soldiers. Just, you can't really make a mistake. You can get paint in the wrong area, but you can fix it. There's nothing about painting that is immutable and forever wrecked. That's for me what a real mistake is, when you do something that can't be corrected. So this is just trying until you get it right. And it's supposed to be fun. Now, I understand that sometimes you spend hours and hours and hours painting something, and then you do something that ruins some of the work that you'd put in, and you're like, "Oh my God, I'm such a fucking idiot." Get nervous about it. I understand, but it's the best thing about the way I try to paint models is that I don't feel that way about my models that much. I don't worry that I'm gonna mess it up. That often. Yeah, you can see it here. Look at that. It's pretty good. Pretty bad one. Still hurting a little bit when I squeeze it too much. This is sort of verging into non-metallic metal territory, which I didn't really want to do. But welcome, horns fan. We'll correct. Tell you what, the hardest part for me now that I've finished basically painting all of these, is going to be the armory bits, which I'm going to paint next. And maybe I'll do a full video on how to paint them, but it's not a bad idea, actually. Remember that, dinner. No, this is I'm sort of pretty fortunate, mate. I got sent an advanced copy of just the models, not the game, just the figures themselves, so I could put together some tutorials. So this is an advanced copy of just the models. Yeah. And let me share with all of you great people in the chat the first episode, which is actually uploaded, but is not currently viewable. So, there you go. You can all watch the first episode in advance. Thanks, mate. Yeah, the boat for this game has actually landed in Australia, and I think there's one that's landed in the USA as well. So the game's probably only a few weeks away from arriving to some lucky sods. We'll probably get the first copies in Australia because, well, we've probably only got about 100 copies, maybe, across all of Australia. So it's likely that we'll get ours sent out in the next few weeks, which would be cool. Used to work for the State Bank of Victoria. That's awesome, mate. Why don't you do it now? I could use $500 a week. Good old VB. Okay, let's go. All right, so now what I think I'm going to do is do lots of washes on that armor. Yes, the old Massive Darkness. We played that the other week. It was pretty fun. Not my favorite game in terms of dungeon crawlers, but it's enjoyable enough. Question I always ask myself when playing a dungeon crawler is this better than Gloomhaven, or is this better than Descent, which is for us, for our group, we've got five players, so Descent's pretty good. If you've only got four, probably less good. Second edition, my friend. Third edition is not one that is I have connected with all that well. Yep, that is an excellent observation, and I think you're probably bang on. We have a pretty dedicated group. We play every week, so for us, that type of game, we don't often have a lot of call for it, but I've got to tell you, Jet, I was born 5 years after that. Yeah, good question, Horns fan. It was this one, which is a HP CS and a Water Eclipse. But I actually have two. This one, which is what I normally use for like base coating and varnish and stuff, and then I have this one, which is my detail brush, which is the Iwata HP B Plus. In the first, the contrast paint, Black Templar, was the color I used. I find contrast paints through the airbrush to be an excellent, really excellent way to just filter the color and change the tone. Yeah, I'm very pro contrast paints, not because I'm pro Games Workshop, but because I am pro any product that is good. And I find them to be excellent. Thank you, mate. Yes, do it, Jet. And then move here and live here forever. So what we established, chains and maybe the Teutonic cross. Or keys. Keys was a good suggestion. Quite like the idea of keys, actually. Maybe we should do keys, but I think I've got a cross keys transfer sitting over there. Maybe I should just cheat. That's always good for your video tutorials. Just show everyone me painting keys and then just wipe. And then switch over to the Oh, my girlfriend would love to do that. She's obsessed with planes. Yeah, I haven't been to Hong Kong. I've been to a couple of the countries in that area. Been to Sri Lanka. It's pretty cool. Indonesia, Malaysia. G'day, Harrison. I'm living the dream here, mate. How are you doing? Thank you. Hopefully, inspiration so that people want to paint more. Yeah, there's a few sort of pretty key things about painting these figures, which is why I hope that people get to see that video. I know Toby from Shadowborne's also planning on doing a little video just to share the same sort of stuff. So yeah, hopefully the message gets out to a variety of places through a variety of means. Absolutely, they are, yes. So yeah, I haven't finished them yet. I've just got the voiceovers to do on the first. Well, I've actually done the first five. I've edited the first five, but yeah, the voiceovers. take a little while. So I'm going to hopefully do some of those maybe tonight. And then, yeah, I'll probably periodically release an episode every couple of days for the next few weeks once I get them done. I think you'll probably see Shadowborne is gonna talk about him in the next update. It is absolutely just consistency and practice. If we should do a little cheeky Reed Richards here. Yeah, let's do it. G'day, Paul.
Hey, Paul. Hey, Paul.
They're pretty important. But they're not important to do crazy, like hyper detailed eyes. What you really just need is the spot of white to give the little reflective sheen. I'm usually all right at painting eyes, but I've found these ones to be a little more challenging than normal. That is a bad idea. There we go. All right, now just a tiny, if we can manage it, little. Tell you what, I reckon I am starting to notice my eyesight getting worse because I reckon I used to be better at doing eyes than I am now. Cool. All right. Maybe I will. Maybe I won't. Okay, so, well, my plan is, let me just get this green out. Little bit of everything all of the time. Someone may have been watching the YouTube by Burnham stuff. I have written tutorials and I have done classes, but yeah, mostly just doing this these days. Look all. I've got my process down pat. And that's an important thing to understand. That I am good at what I'm doing right now because this is something that I've been doing for a long time. This is the way that I approach painting toy soldiers, but what works for me doesn't necessarily mean it'll work for you. Important to find your own approach and sometimes that can be borrowing things from other people and sometimes that's doing it all same way another person does it and sometimes it's just going your own way. Everyone starts somewhere, mate. Me as well. Yay, let's go. Go your way. You can call it another lonely day, another lonely day. Is it the right thing to do? No, I have been thinking for a little while about doing a Patreon. And if that's something I want to invest my time in. And one of my I guess concerns about doing a Patreon is what am I going to add? So many great painters and people that do Patreons, and think what I've landed on that I can do that is a little bit unique is good paint jobs fast. They're not great paint jobs, but they're good. Maybe that's what people would be interested in. Oh, daddy boy, the pipes are closing from glen to glen in every Irish bar. Tis you that keeps my heart in Ireland. Oh, Danny boy, oh, Danny boy. I love you so. Halloween. No. The pipes are calling. No, look, mate, I am pretty good, and I am aware of that, and I am not afraid to tell people that I'm pretty good, but there are many, many painters that are significantly better than me, and that is okay. I am very comfortable with where I rank in the echelons of painters. Very comfortable. Go look up Kirill Knave. Go look up Mark Masklins. Go look up Roman Lepart. Alfonso Giraldez. David Roba. Ruben Martinez. Robert Carlson. Christoph Kobylchek. Michael Pizarski. Natalia Arach. Can keep going if you want. Absolutely, mate. But doesn't necessarily mean there's someone who works harder than you. That's the difference. The Rock's got a great saying. Always be the hardest worker in the room. G'day, Ice Cream Dave. That's an interesting question. My for what I look for as a painter, I just gravitate towards cool stuff. Like what I can paint. Sometimes I'll look at a piece and go, oh, I don't know if I can paint that well. But usually I'll still, if I think it's cool, buy it anyway and use it as a challenge. But like, for example, Dave Colwell, another Aussie painter, we were talking the other day about the latest Lucas sculpt, and it's the Pied Piper of with some cool dudes, and it looks really good, and I was just like, oh, it's just not for me. It doesn't appeal to me as a painter. It doesn't appeal to me in terms of what I want out of a painting experience, so I'm not going to get it. And he's like, yep, I feel the same way. G'day, All Might. And he was like, it's unusual for both of us to not like a Lucas, but he was on the same sort of page. So, but having said that, it is still objectively cool. Like, I love it and I love what Lucas does, but when I look at it, I'm just not excited to paint it. So I guess that's the answer to your question. What I look for in a piece is, am I excited to paint it? No, mate, just as soon as I finish doing these videos for the tutorials, I'll change it to, I'll change it back. You're right, Dave. That's what we're here for, mate. G'day, Illicit Owl. Good morning to you. Oh, it's a wonderful Sunday. I'm very enthusiastic about painting toy soldiers. Have some games to be played later on today, so it's a wonderful day. All right, it's time. And now we'll actually do what the topic of this video is. Let's do the grass. All right, so I think we're gonna do. That's interesting. Yeah, not really. Craft World inspired, but I guess in a way it is. Because I used a blue base coat. No, unfortunately not, Dave. I would love to be at Monty this year. But just with travel from Australia, it's still pretty it's gotten significantly better, but I'm just still a bit gun shy about it. Figured I'll just wait till next year when everything's calmed down a bit. It's very expensive still too. Even more so for me. But yeah, ne next year I hope I'll be at both SMC and Monty. Oh, excellent, mate. Is it your first time or? Awesome. Who's your friend? It's not Eric Swinson, is it? I love Eric. He's a great man. He had You had an excellent first time at Monty. He picked up gold in the open fantasy comp with his World of Warcraft orc. Ah, that's awesome, mate. Yeah, now he's a wonderful dude, and I bought one of his models actually. The latest chick on a horse. I am in the process of buying it. He's a much better painter than me. Significantly better painter. And he's pretty quick too. Comes from being a commission painter for Privateer Press. But I'm taller than him. So I got that all over him. That's about all I got on him. Yeah, I got about, geez, I think I got about 3 or 4 inches on him. There. All right, let's do some free handing, shall we? Join me. All right, so what do we want to free hand on this space? So let's do chains on this one. Thanks, mate. Appreciate you stopping by. Tell Eric I said g'day. Yeah, what are you, like 6'4" or something, aren't you, man? Yep, I'm 6'7". I put everyone in the category of short. You do. You certainly have me covered in the girth stakes. My approach to doing freehand is pretty straightforward, right? You just plan it out with a little sketch like this, like what I've done. And then you use the color around it to just neaten it up. And then you just do a little bit of highlighting or a little bit of Bobby Dazzlers, and you're good. Well, I'll tell you the other thing that's important about freehand. This is a counterintuitive one. You want to use a not dilute paint. You want your paint to almost be almost drying, just at that point where it's about to be drying on the tip. Almost. If your paint's too thin, it'll fly all over the place. I'm in chains. I'm in chains. Thank you, Quiff. And now I think we will just try and reinforce a little bit. I wanna kiss you, but I want it too much, too much. I wanna taste you, but your lips are venomous poison. And your poison running through my veins, yeah, poison. I don't wanna break these chains. Poison. There's needles and pins and pins. Your poison running through my veins, yeah, poison. Nothing's fine, I'm torn. I'm all out of faith. This is how I feel. Cold and I am shamed. Lying naked on the floor. Illusion never changed into something real. I'm wide awake and I can see a perfect sky is torn. You're a little late. I'm already torn. All right, and here's the greatest step of doing freehand. Just go a tiny little airbrush blast of color, or you can just do this with a glaze. Just tiny, tiny little layer. Just integrates it into the environment. Perfect. Chains. You're a little late. I'm already torn. Hello there, Andrew. Happy Sunday. There's needles and pins and pins. All right. Maybe I'll just stick with my idea of a cross. Sunday stream's good, mate. G'day, Wampa. What's going on? How's your streaming going, mate? You're winning? Well done. All right. That's my first step, is to just build out the shape for you, buddy. Awesome. Excited about the Viking. Little Cholly, thanks, buddy. It's very good of you. Needles and pins and pins. This is the thing I think about freehand. I think people get really worried that they're gonna mess it up. And they're like, oh, it's gonna ruin all the work I've done and et cetera, et cetera. And look, that's absolutely a possibility. But usually you don't do freehand on areas that require a lot of fixing or difficult fixing work. So Yeah, buddy, thanks for stopping by and for the pep talk. Thanks, buddy. Is it just me or is this not looking very good? The shape of the shield isn't right for this design that I'm trying to go for. Or do we just go heavily into the chain approach and just do some chains like around here? Or we go with the keys. The keys is maybe the go. Let's try the keys. I think the keys are already shaping better. I think that's much better. Cool. All right. Just fits the shape. Everyone should feel good about their painting, mate. Good. You may find that some pieces don't feel better than the last. That's also okay. In fact, as you get better, that feeling happens more frequently, which is really annoying. Don't touch. I wanna kiss you, but your lips are venomous poison. Your poison running through my face. Veins, not face, Tenno. Good one. Poison running through my face. Benny and Bunny and Mole Man went to karaoke last night. Absolute legends. Did you guys well, Bucks? It was on Bunny's Instagram. She did a story on it. Or Ben's. We'll carry on. We'll carry on. Oh, you're never meant to meet him. No memory, we'll carry on. It did look like that, didn't it? There is every possibility that this is not going to make my videos. I am not enjoying anything that I am painting on this shield at the moment. Very close to it, mate, yes. Indeed. The July 1st would be the next two episodes of Stranger Things. Yeah, one I'm probably not sure yet. Because Oathsworn, the game is actually scheduled to arrive in the next few weeks, and there's a whole pile of figures that are monster figures that I'd also like to paint, but I don't think I will be doing them on stream because spoil the game for anyone. So, yeah. Maybe off stream for a little bit, maybe. I'm not sure. Well, I do need to finish the bus that I'm working on. The Lyra. I do indeed need to paint the arms, you are right. I suppose we could do on stream, couldn't we? General tip of Big Dano is anytime you're not happy with how something's looking, just do a bit of weathering on it. Always make it look better. Yeah, I'm probably going to put together a single video for painting the armory and showcasing how I do that, but I haven't really gotten too far into thinking about that side of it yet, because I've really just been focused on finishing this. Yeah, that is a genuine top tip, that one. If you don't like something, just weather the fuck out of it. This is another good one. Just go the old streaks. All right. I think we will call this attempted freehand a failure. And just use the chains on the back for the topic. All right, so I am just about finished the whole Oathsworn series. How exciting. I do actually have to paint one more thing for the video tutorial, which is I suppose I don't need to do that. I could use the feathers on the other guy. Gotta do the hawks for the falconer. Oh, I suppose they're falcons, aren't they? Don't know. Fucking mug. Cool. I'm okay with it. Looks fine. Yeah, good suggestion, Bob Zombio. Single chain. Yep. I mean the chains are probably a better option than the keys, but I think at this point I'm okay with them how they look. They're not perfect, but they're okay. And the objective of the series is to show how to do a topic, how to do a task, and I did that with the keys, or sorry, the chain on the back, so it's probably sufficient. Are you surprised, Robbie, that I would monster through something in a rapid pace? Does that surprise you? Fair enough then, mate. All right, I think we are done with the non-airbrush, or sorry, non-metallic stuff. So I will take this guy outside and give him a quick varnish. And then we will finish the medals. But your lips are venomous poison. But I want it too much, too much. I want to taste you, but your lips are venomous poison. Both, my friend, both. I have found that the rattle can varnish creates a more even finish. And looks better. And is much better for protection. So. Yep, Bucks knows what's up. Yes, exactly. I use the AK Ultramat heaps during the process because it helps you get a better picture of the piece, but in terms of actual protective finish. That's why I use an enamel. Not usually, no. So what you're talking about there is actually just the satin, the contrast you're getting between a satin color and a matte color. So when you have all matte, everything is really more pastel. What did I do? Oh, modding that. Mate, I told you I'd make you mod, and you're like, I'm never on. Yes. Yep, no, I think mental is a good way to describe what you just said there, Kung Fu. and needles and pins. I'm glad you're okay. It's never not an amazing video to show people, mate. Yeah, no, this is the stuff. TS80, Tamiya, TS80, it's the go. It's replaced testers for me for two reasons. One, I couldn't get testers for a long time, but I think this stuff's actually better anyway. Yeah. Just go a tiny little bit of verdigris or something on these little metal bits. I think that'll look nice. You know the saying, mate, fortune favours the bold. Well, there's a reason I'm in Gryffindor. What test? The Gryffindor test? I did. I did, absolutely. And I absolutely did get Gryffindor. My girlfriend, who is a Slytherin, does not enjoy either spending time with me or the fact that I'm a Gryffindor. None of the answers tell me to stop. I want to kiss you, but I want it too much. Yeah, no, I could be a Hufflepuff. I'd be a good Hufflepuff, I reckon. So you don't have to fucking do anything other than be shit. In other words, everyone's a good Hufflepuff. Gryffindor. She actually put it up a couple of days ago for people that are her friends, mate. Just FYI. Just FYI. I know. That was the exact point that I was making, Andrew. Oh, absolutely, her loss. Agreed. Hey, when's PAX, by the way? Is that soon? Or mine. But it's not my kind of scene, oh yeah. Footprints on the other side. Remind me where I've been, oh yeah. I watch from the other side. All right, now. Okay, let's go. All right, and now for the final step. Just want to add some little scratches on the black armor. Yes. Where he was before. Ah, did it? Cool, man. All right, maybe just a couple of little rusty boys. Done. Me? I never like I played a fair bit of Blood Bowl, but not ever like at the same time as everyone else in a way, sort of. Like Blood Bowl for me was like I played it online heaps and I played it with mates back in the day. But it was never like it was never a game that took over my gaming group. Same way that like Necromunda did, or yeah, see, I never got into it at that degree. I sort of wish I did, but Well, I was a dwarf player, mate, so I don't think I'd regret that. I think I'd be very excited about that. Yep, I like this guy. He may be my favorite one that I've done. Good work, Dano. Congratulations. All right. Ooh, let's do this, friends, since we've finished. Let's turn my face back on. Boom. Hello, everyone. Yes. And then let's get a little bit of this gear happening. I can change this up now. Ooh, zoom out, Deno. Ooh, there's my arm. What did I do there? That's an all-timer. I don't know what I've done there. Yeah. Office works, my friend. Office works. Office works, mate. The idea came from Officeworks. G'day, Nates. Only the penitent man shall pass. Yep, good old Officeworks. Well, look. They look okay. See you, Wampa, you're a champion. These are the six figures I have left to finish for the models that I've received. So I reckon that'll take me all of about a day. But yeah. I don't know what I pressed on the camera, but it looks like shit on the screen. What did I press? What button did I press? pressed a button of some description. This one, maybe? Yeah, here you go, have it. I'll show you. You can have a little tour of my studio. I've done this before, but yeah, I built this paint rack myself. I'm not a handyman, but I went to Bunnings, which is like a hardware store, and they had offcuts, and the offcuts were of this, and they were about this wide, and I was like, man, I reckon I could stack those into a paint rack. And so I did, and I stacked 5 of them into a paint rack and put it there. And it's been awesome. It's been the best thing I did. Then here's my screen. Hello, everyone. This is my wet palette area just here. And my airbrush area set up there. Maybe I'll switch the focus there. Yep. And this is where I keep all of my work in progress stuff. Up here. Unfortunately, I've got this big camera here at the moment, but that's filming the palette for my tutorials. Yeah, love Bunnings, eh? Here's my paint brush holder, also from Officeworks. I use about 3 of those. The ones that I use just sit here. So, what else we got? Here's my fancy computer with its fancy lights. Woo! Cool. And then up here I have a microphone here. This is my new microphone, which is just out of shot. You can just see it here. And then what else we got? Oh yeah, then behind me. Have I shown behind me? I think I've shown behind me. So up there is where I keep my cardboard, black cardboard I got from Officeworks. And that's some next projects, some big projects. Up there is the Zodiac project and the Nico Galaxy project. And then here is all my plinths that I've got stored and my diorama and then my pile of stuff to do. And then this is all of my terrain gear that I have there and more terrain gear over there. And then down here is just stuff, sorted stuff. Yeah, try to be organized. Try to be. But yeah, I have no idea what I did to this camera. Oh, hang on, that's the button. That's what I pressed. Gotcha. Yeah, the hydration is actually for my wet palette, believe it or not. It is. Yeah, everything is just perfectly in order where I need it. I don't have to move from this chair. I can just feel like grab that, everything all of the time. A little bit of everything all of the time. There we go. Now it looks better. Turn off auto exposure now, did I? Cool. I'm pretty happy with this collection, friends. We're just gonna take some photos of the last few dudes. Yes, PSK. Fight. So this series of videos will come out on YouTube in the next probably 2 weeks. I've just got to do the voiceovers. Most of the editing is pretty much done. And I am going to do a playthrough on YouTube as well of this game, which would be cool. These are from a game called Oathsworn Into the Deepwood, PSK. Yes, very cool. This guy, yeah, this guy's awesome. Yeah, thanks, mate. As I said, I'm not much of a I'm much of a Discord user, but I might pop my head in and ask some questions on occasion. Oh yeah, this guy, yeah. Fuck yeah. So, yeah, I'm pretty pleased. Pretty pleased with the outcome. Really don't know which one my favorite is, but yeah. Cool. All right, so I've got to go film this guy for a little 360 spinny video. And I've got to film and take some photos of him as well. And same for these. Think I've done the rest of them. Did the witch, yeah, did the penitent, yeah, they're all done. Cool. These little hawks are the last thing I've got to paint, I think, for the filming, for painting feathers. So that's the last cab off the rank. So we might do them and some arms tomorrow night, I think. Cool. All right. Well, they're doing a second Kickstarter, in when are they doing it? October, I think they said. Come on, Dan. Yeah, why'd it have to be feathers? Cool. So that's the last piece of the puzzle. They have little plastic flight stands. Should I do bases? Sandy bases for them. Nah, don't think so. Do want to fill that in, maybe. There's a bit of weight to it. Nah, cool. All right. This has been a glorious. I do have the other weapons for everyone, PSK. I've got to paint them though. So we might. I think what we'll do is we'll just pick a couple of weapons for each one. So here's the bear that we'll paint. We won't paint them all. So I really like this scythe. Yeah, it's got the claws. Haven't tested it yet. That's next. The next plan. So maybe I'll just pick two weapons for each person. Well, he's got these big swingy. Look at this crazy shit. Oh. Raw. Nice. Oh, I like these. No, it's all physical, mate. Don't think you can buy STL for these. I do like these axes. Oof. I'm partial to axes. Yeah, I could, mate, but there's also other things I could paint with my time. And also, I could play games with my cool soldiers that I painted. All right, awesome. Well, friends, it's been a pleasure. Hope you've had fun. We'll go find someone to raid now. Yes, Bucks, tell me what. Go check that out if you want to see the first video. I'm down for anything Francesco does, mate. Anything. Literally anything I'm down for. All right, so who do we have painting miniature figures? Reiner72 raided us the other day. He's a good dude. See you, Paul. Maybe we should raid Reiner. Thanks, mate. Yeah, let's go raid Reiner. He's a good dude. Oh, Meg's on. I raided her last week. Friends, you're all amazing. Back tomorrow for Party Monday. I'll probably be painting feathers on hawks and some weapons. Sweet. Have fun. Peace.